Cyber attacks, and not just from one side, are suddenly part of this story. We're going to ask retired Green Beret Joe Kent about that. He is back with us after a technical snafu. Joe Kent, great to see you. So what do you think a wise response to this invasion from the United States would be at this point?
Well, Tucker, it's not opening up a new front, and that front would be a cyber attack. I know there's people in the Biden administration, there's lawmakers, and there's hawks offering up our cyber capabilities, and we do have cyber capabilities. However, opening up a new front and directly attacking Russia with a cyber attack would be viewed as an act of aggression and just plunge us further into this conflict. What we should be looking for is every single opportunity that we have to dialogue with Putin and offer him a off ramp, in particular taking NATO off the table, as opposed to beating the war drums even more. And also our cyber capabilities, considering how much infiltration there is in our own cyber network coming from China, is extremely unwise at this juncture.
So Mark Warner, who's the chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, described a Russian cyber attack against Ukraine and potentially NATO allies like Lithuania and Poland as an act of war. I think that's commonly acknowledged, that a cyber attack that takes infrastructure offline or shuts down hospitals, that is an act of war. Is that commonly defined, I think?
Absolutely. In this day and age, a cyber attack is most certainly an act of war. So we should be very cautious before we even recklessly discuss putting that out there. I think we should be very cautious with that. And again, looking for off-roads, ways to de-escalate and not continue this march towards a total war in Europe.
Yeah. You can be upset and wise at the same time. It's possible. Joe Kent, great to see you tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.